Hi, everyone. My name is Vinod Arvind Dakshin. I work as an HR leader in the Bay Area, and I'm going to be doing a bunch of mock interviews today. So I have Harsh from IIT Palakkad in front of me today, and I'm going to jump into the mock interview process. So Harsh, you kind of know the drill. I'll ask you some questions followed by a debrief. So Harsh, why don't you begin by giving me a quick introduction about yourself? Walk me through your resume in 2 to 3 minutes.
I'm Harsh Sharma. I'm currently pursuing my Master's of Science in Physics from IIT Palakkad. My research interests are in the area of quantum mechanics and more generally in quantum criticality and quantum phase transition. I pursued my Bachelor's of Science in Honors from Pandit Ravi Shankar Shukla University, Raipur, where I developed most of my basic understanding that I have in physics. I am well versed in Python, HTML, LaTeX, C, C++, and other common programming languages. Also, I have experience in handling XSPICE. It is similar to Arduino, but it has been developed in India. Also, I have been working on a project similar to my research interests, that is in quantum criticality, under Dr. Uma Divakaran. She is a faculty in physics department from IIT Palakkad. My hobbies include reading, cooking, and watching television. That's all.
Okay. Okay, Harsh, great answer. So let's jump into a couple of questions where I want you to reflect from a STAR point of view. When I say STAR framework or STAR point of view, what I'm saying is, if you give me an answer to the question on the basis of what you've done in the past by looking at an example and talking about what the situation was when you were asked to take up this project or work, and what is the work allocated to you, what did you do, and what are the results? That's really the framework I'm looking at. So I'm sure you handled multiple projects in the past in terms of working either in the office or in your personal life. So can you give me an example where you had to work with a large team in terms of getting work done? Can you walk me through the details and shed some light in terms of how things progressed?
So since I joined into an institute, which was new in respect to like it was recently established, a few years ago. So similarly, our hostel was also new. So when I joined there in my second year, I was on the position of mess president in Power Grid Hostel. So during that time, the previous mess that was catering, we had some issues like food quality was not great. And due to some other conflicts between the caterer and the students, he left on such a short notice that we had to arrange a new caterer for our mess. So it was like at the starting of when I started at that position. So my task was to find a new caterer, get an agreement done with him, and also to coordinate with the students in the hostel and with the caterer so that we get a good quality of food. So this was a pretty tough task for me. So the first thing that I did was I divided the task into sub tasks like we have to find a caterer. Since the hostel is new, we don't have equipments or necessary utensils needed to run a mess. So we had to purchase those. We had to take an inventory on what food items did we receive and how much was utilized from that. So for all those tasks, I selected some of my classmates and some residents in the hostel and then divided the task among them and coordinated with them. So we found a totally new caterer. We discussed with him what we wanted as the menu for the mess. We regularly maintained the food quality, took feedback from the students and shared it with the mess caterer, and finally established the whole mess and it was is running great, but now since because of COVID, it has come to a halt.
How do you know it's running great? Have you done some measurement?
Yes, so we regularly took feedbacks from the students, like what was the quality of food, was the quantity better, was it affordable for them. Also, in the meantime, we also coordinated with the caterer and asked if he could generate some profit while keeping us affordable for it. So I also handled the accounts part of it.
Awesome. Okay, Harsh, let me move on to my next question. So this is more about the mistakes you have made and how you have learned from it. So can you go back to a time in terms of a place where you had to stretch yourself? You did your best, but at the end of the day, it did not work out. And what did you learn from that experience?
I can share one experience from when we had to make a science project for National Science Day competition.
Okay.
Our purpose was to make a beehive air cooler, which would help us in reducing the room temperature with at very affordable rates. So we had all the plans worked out. So it was like we have an earthen pot and we pass air through it, and the air that comes out of its nozzle would be relatively cooler. So we worked out all our plan. We started working on it, but it was not undergoing like how we expected it would cool. So we had to improvise there. We worked really hard, but we couldn't get what we expected from it. So like we couldn't win that competition, but during the process, we learned a lot of things. There was a lot of physics. Even though we couldn't complete it, we tried to make a little bit of whatever we had. We tried to explain others how it would have worked, and that was.
When you look back at what happened, if you were to get a second shot at doing this once again, other than the learning physics part of it, what else would you do differently?
I would have given spent more time in working on it, because we did it on such a short notice. I guess it was not feasible for us to make it. So if I would get a next chance, I would try investing more time in it and looking at all the things or all the components with a different point of view, so I could get that working.
Was there any other gaps in terms of working with the team or working on close deadlines where you wish you had done things better?
I guess my communication skills would have made a lot of impact, because I find it hard to communicate with my team members at that time, but surely I would do better now.
Okay. So Harsh, I asked you three questions and I think you gave me three solid answers. So shall we do a debrief?
Sure.
Harsh, I'm very impressed by the way you did this interview process. I think you're well prepared. You look very professional, by the way. I mean, you look professional. I think you've done your homework. I asked you a lot of very difficult questions. Trust me, I mean, I've done hundreds of interviews and some of the questions I asked you is not easy questions. People don't find it easy to answer. So what struck me in your conversation firstly is that I think you are very good in communication. I think that definitely is going to be a big advantage to you when you go through the placement process. So having a very clear, calm communication is something which not everyone has. So I think that's going to be a good win for you. And I would say that let's go to the first question, second question, and the third question. So the first question I asked you was walk me through your resume. And I think you touched upon a bunch of things in terms of looking through your resume. And the point you need to keep remembering is that I've probably not had a chance to look at your resume. So you are telling me what your resume is, but you don't need to walk through every component of your resume. So depending on which company you are going to be talking to, you're going to talk about those things which matter for the company. you get what I'm saying? So for example, if you're going to be interviewing with, say, a core company where you want to get placed, you want to talk about specifically about things like, for example, that you have numerical skills, you have coding skills. So you want to draw your attention to those things which stand out in your resume. So maybe make a list of 5 things you want to tell the interviewers, that like keep a list in the back of your mind. And when they ask you to walk through your resume, try to focus on those 5 things as much as possible, because the recruiter is not going to remember everything. All they remember is, okay, what did you tell them during the first couple of minutes? And that's all you want to focus on. So just keep the focus on a bunch of things which are important to not just you, but also to the recruiter. So look at it from a recruiter's point of view. That will help. I saw you looking down. I was not sure if you're reading from a piece of paper or you were just looking at me and talking. Did you have a piece of paper with you?
No.
Okay, great. Then I think it was awesome. You were talking so smoothly that I thought you probably had a piece of paper. But again, that's, I think, the problem with Zoom and all that is I don't know what's happening at the other end. So something I had the back of my mind. What's that?
It is difficult to
yes,
focus
I agree.
On camera when I can see you.
No, fair point. I know it's not easy. Maybe just being a little expressive in terms of moving your hands a little, right? Will make it look more natural. I think that could be something you kind of look at. The second question, as you're on teamwork, I thought you gave an excellent example. Being a mess president is actually a big piece of work. And I think it's a very professional answer. I mean, even good business school students don't give good answers. So I was very impressed by your answer. I mean, again, I wanted you to focus a little bit on the metrics because, again, end of the day, right, when you do some piece of work, how do you evaluate whether it's successful? You have to go to some numbers or survey and talk about what you measured and how you found that successful. So try to put in some numbers at the end of every example you give, because that'll give a very good image of yourself. The mischief I asked you to talk about is actually a very tricky question. Not many people give a good answer. I liked your answer. You talked about the science project, some of the things you learned from it. I tried to probe a little further to check if you really did it or if you're just like making up a story, but it looks like you did that work. So very happy with that answer. So overall, Harsh, I think you're very well prepared. I mean, if you had asked me, you could even sit for consulting companies or even finance companies, because they all look for very good communication skills. And I think you have those skills. So I'm very optimistic about your interviewing prospects.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, Harsh, great talking to you. So that's it from my end. Again, if you have any further questions, right, I mean, feel free to reach out to me and I'll be there to answer any questions. But I don't think you should have any hassles during the interview process, because I think you're going to be facing it in a couple of months, isn't it?
Yes.
Awesome. I think you're well prepared. All the best, Harsh.
Thank you, sir.
Awesome. Take care, buddy. So I'm going to jump to my second interview right now, and I have Dilip here. So Dilip, you are an undergraduate student from IIT Palakkad in mechanical engineering. Is that correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay, great. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to ask you to introduce yourself as the first question and then ask you a couple of other questions. And I'll do a debrief after maybe 10 minutes. So maybe three questions of 3 minutes each, and I'll close with a debrief. So Dilip, let's jump straight in. So my first question to you is, can you walk me through your resume and touch upon what are the things which motivate you?
Yes, sir. So this is Dilip and I'm from Hyderabad. So after completing my 12th in Chaitanya College, I have decided to choose IIT Palakkad and under mechanical branch. And I have chosen mechanical branch that's just out of my curiosity and interest towards machines. And my hobbies are playing cricket and chess, and writing stories and listening to music. And I always believe that I'm a person who is interested in exploring new things. So I believe that strongly. So I have been doing that constantly during my 3 years of undergraduation. And one of which is I've developed few technical skills to keep myself engaged. So those are designing softwares like AutoCAD and Fusion 360. And programming languages like Python and C and HTML and CSS. And apart from these, I have been involved in few projects during my first year of undergraduation, that is robotic arm and smart dustbin. And those two projects were like a good lessons in terms of how to deal a team and how to divide the project among ourselves and sort it out in a proper way. And later in my second year, I have been involved in one of our finest project, that is infrared imaging of tooth decay. So I'm proud to say that that project has been selected as one of the winner of Young Innovators Program. And apart from that, I was also involved in position of responsibilities in the college under marketing head for Petricore 21, that is a college fest, mm-hmm. and public relation officer for MESA. The MESA is a students club of mechanical students. And later, I have done my internship in Kyalik Private Limited Company under the project ultrasonic cutting tool development and design of a scale remover in oil industry. So that was a very good project to like that inculcated research skills in me. Like I have been reading many papers and like did a wide range of research on different tools and designs. And later, I have written an exam, National Engineering's Olympiad. So the organization for being selected for second round, they offered me an internship in Excel automation. There I learned how to make macros and different dashboards of given data. Mm-hmm. So, and these are my internships and all the thing which covers in the resume. And later I always said you earlier that I'd like to explore new things because I believe that when you explore new things, like that would bring the best out from us. And like, I would be much interested to work in a challenging environment because constantly I've been trying many new things throughout my undergraduation. So that quality have been developed in me. So, and I see myself placed in a automotive industry to explore much and more better things. And down the line, 5 to 8 years, I see myself as a senior position, taking up new and challenging projects and getting a wide range of exposure globally. Thank you.
Awesome, Dilip. So let's just dig in into some of the things you mentioned. So you mentioned that you've done a bunch of internships and also you worked on a couple of positions of responsibility in IIT Palakkad. So yes. Why don't you talk about any one of the roles in terms of which one was the role which really stands out during your time at IIT Palakkad, where you had a chance to manage a lot of responsibilities and take a leadership role. So can you talk me about what the situation was in terms of when you took the role, what was the work allocated to you, what did you do, and what were the results?
Okay. So like there are two situations. One was...
Just pick one, which is the most important, and talk me through it.
Yeah, like can I say a like situation where I faced in my schooling?
You can choose whatever you want, whatever shows sure. you in very good light, whether in college or in school.
Yeah, so there was a situation like that was ending of my 10th standard during the December and February period. Okay. So I have been in a complex situation, like I should be preparing for my examination. And further, I have been in a role of house captain for the school. So I need to represent that house for my annual day, which was in January. And further, I was also into a school team of cricket and chess. So I need to manage these three things further. So when I took my suggestion from my teachers and parents, they were saying that it's pretty difficult to manage three things at one time. And you may be less efficient or may lose something like maybe academics, you may spoil your 10th grades. Mm-hmm. So what I did, like I have decided like, once you begin to start something, you should not leave in the middle, right? So like you need to give a proper ending for that. So like I have planned it, like I have chosen few tactics, like I have used my recess periods to get more practice for sports and games. And further, I have squeezed my sleeping hours so that I could get good preparation time for academics. And like I have taken permission for my teachers and principal so that I could skip few like common period so that I could get more time to hold my responsibility as a captain so that I could take good part in organizing the events for my annual day. Mm-hmm. So that was of course a stressful period for a couple of months, but still I feel that that's the period where I inculcated that we can manage multiple things. It's not that we should give up if we have two or three things to do parallelly. So if we keep a proper schedule and divide the time of a day in particular periods, then like we can get good efficiency from those work too.
Okay, Dilip, can you also pivot and also talk about maybe a time when you had to work with a smaller team of people and you've done similar work?
Yes, sure. Like I already mentioned, the project which have been allotted during my first year. That is a robotic arm. It's there in my resume. So that's the first hands-on work I have been allotted in my life. That's the first project. And mm-hmm. later, that's the only project, like, I have been leading the team. So it's the first experience. So that project, like, taught me many lessons in terms of how to lead the team. Because, like, initially, I didn't take the project very seriously, because that's the time we are just starting the undergraduation, like, making new friends and exploring new things, clubs and new skills. So, like, at that time, the priority I gave for the project was pretty low. And later, I forgot that I was the leader, so I should be a first person who should be more responsible, right? So I didn't do that. I was skipping the deadlines. And, like, later, we started the project just 1 month before the submission. So mm-hmm. that's pretty late. And when we started, like, we started a few calculations. And the project was robotic arm, right? So there will be many calculations in terms of torque and force balancing. So we started late, but still we managed to do the structure base and all the supporting things. And just before 3 days of submission, there was a big shock. Like, there was a miscalculation in the torque, and we are sure that we could not complete the project in time. So the requirement will not be done, that's for sure. So at that time, we went and we met the mentor, and we said, like, then the madam said, like, when you are not able to complete the project completely, at least minimize few aspects and do it partially. Mm-hmm. So, like, I felt that idea was good. Instead of keeping in the zero, let's do something, like, other than being at zero. So I have a few changes in the design so that the torque and force would be balanced properly. And, like, from, like, a position that we could not do the project, we submit the project, and I'm sure that among the four groups, ours was the only project which could lift the egg up to certain height. So, like, that was a pretty good result from where we placed ourselves from the initial position. But after that project, I understood that from the day one, we should always be involving and interacting with the team properly. And later, we should always divide the work and allot it to each and make everyone responsible. And we should make our group feel that everyone is a team leader in them, because that's very much important so that we would bring the project best out of us.
Great answer. So, going back to what you mentioned, how did you measure the success of a project?
So, I will take the same project as example. Mm-hmm. So what we did, first, the mistakes we did is, like, not dividing the work properly.
No, forget the mistakes. How do you measure success? I mean, I'm just talking about, like, I think at a certain point, you need to make a decision whether your project is going in the right track or not in the right track. So keeping the consequences aside, even before you began the project, like, what did you fix as the success criteria in terms of metrics and data? Let's talk about that, and then you can talk about other things.
Okay, sir. The challenge given to us was, like, we should place an egg and pick the egg and place it in a perpendicular platform, which is a 2 meters distance.
Okay.
So that's the ultimate thing which was given to us. So, like, I feel if the strength and every aspects of the material which have used for the project works well, and if the design looks aesthetic and it looks attractive to the who, like, we can see that wow factor from the participants and other students, right? So that's the thing which I feel as a success. And later, if the challenge which is given to us, that the main condition and criteria that it should pick the egg and place it 2 meters, and if we are ahead, like if we get 2.5, then that would be like a bit more than success.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Dilip, again, we don't have too much time. It's a short meeting. So let me do my debrief in the next couple of minutes.
Sure, so, sir.
The first thing I would say is that when I asked you to walk me through your resume, I think you give a good answer. Firstly, your communication is very good. I think you have a very clear way of communicating. Your communication style is very understandable, so it's easy to relate to. So I think definitely there are some very good positives in terms of being out there, being able to talk and convince people. I think you have all those skills. And I'm very optimistic about your chances when it comes to the interview process, when you're doing the campus placements, because I think overall you bring a lot of confidence to the table. And you're also a person who likes to get into things, likes to get their hands dirty. So all very good traits. I would say that when you talk about the first question, for example, in this case, it was walk me through your resume. Always keep in mind that you are going to talk about a lot of things on your resume, because this is your resume, right? You put so much content out there that you want to talk about everything. But keep in mind that there's a recruiter at the other end. So look at it from the recruiter's point of view. So if, for example, you are recruiting with, say, a core company, or if you're with a consulting company, you want to identify maybe five things you want to touch on absolutely when you talk about your resume. For example, if it's a consulting company, you want to talk about quantitative aptitude, hard work, teamwork. And I think you've done all of these, but you didn't get into it right from the beginning. When I asked you some additional questions, then you went into that direction saying that you have done a lot of additional work. So in terms of some of the schoolwork, some of the work you've done in college. So just customize it accordingly as per who the interviewer is. So you're telling the interviewer what they want to hear. So just keep in mind that your example is great in terms of your walk me through your resume, but do some more rehearsals in terms of customizing it for the audience. I think that's important. But I know that today's session is not easy because you have no idea where I'm coming from. So that's fine. But in the future, if you know who the interviewer is, customize your pitch for the recruiter. That's important. Yes, for the second part of it, which is in terms of responsibilities, I think your school example is very good. The only piece I missed in your school example is that ideally when you're giving an example, when it comes to STAR questions, right? When I say STAR, I'm talking about the situation, task, actions, and results. So you want to talk about a project where you're not just a single contributor, you're working with a team of people. So you want to talk about those sort of examples where you're working with a team, you're trying to get work done together, you're looking for ambitious goal. So there is some learning in the project. But you gave me a great example. But if you can just link it back to some work with the team, that would have made it even better. But it was a good example overall. The third piece was around asking you questions around what did you do during your college days? And the robotics example was a good example. But I would just say that when it comes to STAR questions, right, I'm not sure if you've done this, but make sure you take a piece of paper and write down your answer to as many STAR questions as possible. So
sure,
I've done a separate session for IIT Palakkad students. So I do some bi-weekly conversations with IIT students. It's put up on my YouTube channel. It's like my hobby. It's called Win Career Talks. And there is one video in my channel which talks specifically about STAR questions, how to prepare for STAR interview questions. In that video, I've actually pointed out like 25 to 30 questions which can come at you in terms of STAR questions. So I would say that if you are getting ready for the placement process, I would want you to be a little bit more prepared in terms of an answer. You are good in terms of communicating, but I want you to be more rehearsed in terms of telling exactly what the recruiter has to hear. So write down all the 30 STAR questions, be ready with the answers for each one of those questions. Think about an example in your time. So list down the situation, write it down on paper. What was the task you did? What were the actions you took? What was the results? And I think results is where you need to focus on, because you're going to talk about where you made an impact. And you have to give metrics. You have to share data. That's very, very important when you give a good STAR answer. The better your answer is going to be, or the way it's going to be evaluated, is based on how the results were. So I think your stories are good, but you will need to do a little bit of fine-tuning it, coming up with the right story in terms of practicing it as much as possible. So write it down on paper, practice with your friends if possible, talk to your family members on Zoom, ask them to ask you questions, practice talking about yourself, and I think your answers will get much better. So by the time your actual placements kick in, you'll be in a very good position to get the jobs you're looking for. But I'm very optimistic about your chances.
Thank you, sir.
Do you have any questions for me, Dilip?
Yes, sir. Like, I wanted to ask any other feedback, like in terms of maybe like hesitation. Did you find any hesitation in speaking or something like that?
No, Dilip. I think you're very confident. I don't think that's a problem. Communication is not a problem for you. I think the only issue I would want you to focus on is just be more practiced in terms of whatever you say, right? You should not be surprised to you. So whatever question I ask should also not be a surprise to you. You should have done your homework in advance. The more homework you do, the better your answer is going to be.
Yes, sir. Like, that's it. And thank you for the opportunity.
Awesome, Dilip. Thanks so much. Again, feel free to reach out to me if you have other questions. Okay?
Sure, sir.
Bye. Bye, Dilip.
Bye, sir.
So I have Chaitanya in front of me today. Chaitanya, can you tell me, are you a master's student from IIT Palakkad? Is that your background?
Yes, sir.
So which branch are you majoring in?
geotechnical engineering.
Okay, great. So, Chaitanya, the way I'm going to do today's discussion is that I will ask you maybe 2 to 3 questions and I will do a debrief at the end of it. So the 2 to 3 questions are for 10 minutes and then I'll do a debrief for 5 minutes. So by 15 minutes, you should have done a quick interview. So that's what I'm looking for. So let's jump straight in, Chaitanya. So can you walk me through your resume and tell me yes. what you're passionate about and what interests you?
So I'm Chaitanya. I did my graduation from Guru Nanak Institute, which is in Hyderabad of Telangana state. And I had my polytechnic in a government college. And I did my 10th schooling in a ZPHS school, which is in my nearby home.
Okay.
I did my major project in BTech on frictional behavior of steel sheets. And I am native of Telangana state itself.
Okay. So what sort of jobs interest you, Chaitanya?
I am interested in doing design jobs, design based on geotechnical, some structures like which is will be piling and deep foundation like that. I am interested.
Okay, awesome. So let's move on to my next question. So I want you to reflect about a time in the past, any of your previous experiences in terms of having worked on some couple of the questions I'm going to talk to you about. So if you can share an example in terms of what was the situation in, so we call it a STAR framework in terms of situation, task, analysis, and results. And we want students to use the framework when answering questions. So basically, if you look back at the past, you could share an example where you had to look at the situation. You talked to me about what your task was, which was given to you, what the actions you took were, and what the results were. So let's pick up any project you have done during your undergraduate or master's program where you had to take the initiative to work or lead a project. So can you share any example with me in terms of any project you worked on where you had to work on a lot of challenges and you had to take a lot of initiative?
Yes, sir. I'm really happy to share my undergraduate project. That is, we have done by preparing the equipment by ourselves. At the time, I am leading my team. We are a team of 4 members. So we have to fabricate the equipment. We have to buy the material. So at that time, I have allotted the jobs to individual. There are 2 female girls and 2 female and 2 male. So we gave them to do the theory part and project presentation. And we both male went for bringing the material and fabrication and all. So at that time, it is little difficult to manage these works, but at that time I done well by organizing works in a simple way, and we concluded that project in a correct duration. And what is the funds given for us that will do for that project, we have completed within that funds provided. Yes.
So how do you measure success in your project? So how do you know whether it was successful or not?
Yes, sir. So at the end of our project, we have checked our result, and that are really existed in the practical scenario, which is the application of that one is really good, and what we done, it is correct. And after that, we estimated our time. That time we have completed within the time specified time, and we have completed the project within the budget itself. So these 3 things make us that we are efficient. We are done perfect and done a good job in doing that project.
Very good answer, Chaitanya. Love it. So let's move on to the next question.
Thank you, sir.
Can you talk about an example of a time when you had to work with difficult team members? So give me a different example and talk about a time when you had to work with difficult people and how did you get the project done? Can you walk me through what the situation was? What the introduction was, what the situation was, what did you do, and what is the results of that project?
When we took a project, sir, there is a starting difficulties that we have to
give me a timeline when this happened.
This is the same project what I done in my my undergraduation.
No, let's move to a different. I want you to give me a different example. I know you already shared that same example with me. Can you,
yes,
if possible, give me a different example? If not, you can go back to the same example.
Yeah, there is no such good example, sir. I had done the.
No worries. Go back to it. Okay, no issue. Yep. Yeah, please.
So, in that project, while we starting that, there was a difficulty in selecting the person for that equipment fabrication. So we have took many quotations. We went for many shopkeepers to do that. So at that time, we have to manage the client and we have to that shopkeepers. So we have to manage in between both and we have to fix a amount in between. So at that time, it is faced a little difficulty. After that, everything it gone well. So we have at that time we have to manage both the people as a project doing. We have to manage those people till the end of the project.
Okay.
Yes.
Did you do it under a professor?
This yes.
Project.
Sir.
What is the professor's feedback at the end of the project?
He has submitted. He got a project from Institute of Engineers. At the end of, he able to publish that paper itself, and he told that 70 to 80% results are exactly what we expected. That is it can be appreciable. So we got a good result at the end of this.
Okay, oh, that's fantastic! Why didn't you tell me this before? It's a very good answer. I love it. So Chaitanya, are you fine if I jump to the debrief?
Yeah, sure, sir.
Great. I think we only have a limited time, right? We only got 15 minutes and I basically ask you questions for 10 minutes and give you a debrief. So Chaitanya, I love your answers. I like your enthusiasm. I like your communication. I think it's very good in terms of getting into details and telling me what happened. And you look like a person who understands the nitty-gritties of work, are able to delve deep in and pick up threads and bring it to a conclusion. So I think these are all important traits when it comes to people coming out of IITs. We want people to show initiative, take control, bring things to a conclusion. So I love it that you give some very good examples. In terms of what you could do better overall is that I want you to practice the answers a lot more. The reason why I'm saying that is because let's maybe talk about each one of the questions and I'll tell you like what went well, what could go better. So when I said, walk me through your resume, I expect typically an answer of 2 to 3 minutes. You gave me a good answer, but it's chopped in a minute. So the best students, right, do a lot of practice. So Chaitanya, just remember that talking in Zoom, giving interviews is difficult. It's not easy for anyone. You have to keep practicing. The only way you will pick up is just by practice. So I would say that if you have time, right, call up your friends on Zoom, have a chat with them, ask them to ask you questions and try to answer those questions. So that's kind of how you get more comfortable. So I don't want you to give me short answers. I want you to give me longer answers and I want you to practice as much as possible so that you're ready with a good answer when somebody asks you the question. 100% guaranteed that when you sit through the placement process, you will get this question, walk me through your resume once again. And you have to give an answer which gets into details. And the other thing to keep in mind is that you want to answer it from the recruiter's perspective. So for example, if you're talking to a consulting company, right, you need to understand what does a consulting company look for. They look for people who are good in numbers, who are good in coding. They look for people who work in teams. They're looking for people who can work with large groups of people. They're looking for people who are good in communication. So when you give your walk me through your resume answer, you want to touch on each one of these things. So you're not just walking through your resume, you are also highlighting what makes you special. So that's the way you're presenting yourself. So just keep in mind that you want to bring out those things. And I think you have a good profile. You just need to practice in terms of just bringing it out as much as possible. Going to the second question, your project, I loved your answer. I mean, this is one of the very good answers I got about your project. But two places I want you to focus on a little more is that you jumped straight when I asked you what your project was, you jumped straight into what you did. But please spend some time in terms of the situation and the task. When I say STAR, right, there are four pieces to it: situation, task, actions, and results. You talked a lot about actions. Your answer was fantastic, but you need to also talk about situation. So give me a description of what was the project, who was working on the project, how did this project originate? You told me later that it happened because an organization sponsored it. So I want you to tell that right in the beginning, that this was sponsored for so many lakhs. You were asked to lead the project. So give me the context. I think that helps. So the introduction helps. Likewise, when it comes to the results, you should always close any STAR answer by talking about results, and you need to give data, you need to give numbers in terms of how the project stood out. For example, you gave me a feedback that this project was done within budget. And so you need to tell me what the budgets were, how close you were to the budget. Did you meet 100% of the budget, 90% of the budget? If you went below budget, means you've done a fantastic job. You saved money for the organization. So I want you to get into numbers a little bit when it comes to results. So that would make your answer even better. The third piece was around difficulties. And I would say that again, for these questions, right? Remember the email I sent to all the students saying that practice all these questions, because I'm going to ask you one of these questions. And that's exactly what I did. I asked you one of those questions. So I would say that when it comes to STAR questions, there is possibly maybe 25 to 30 questions which you will get during the interview process. So I run a channel called Win Career Talks, where I specifically talk to IIT students as a hobby. So there is one video in my channel called Preparing for STAR Interviews. In that, I have actually provided a link to 25 to 30 STAR questions. So as homework, I would want you to do before the placement season begins is list down all 25 questions and be ready with an answer for each one of the questions. Take a piece of paper, write down the question, what is your answer going to be? So write in terms of situation, task, analysis, results, what are you going to talk about? Rehearse it, be ready with an answer so that when I ask you any question, it should not be a surprise to you. You should be ready with an answer. So I think your the answer for the difficulties question, I think it gave me a good answer, but the answer is very short. It got done within like 30 seconds to 1 minute. I want you to make it a bit longer. So you need to practice, just add more content, make it bigger so that it fills up the 2 to 3 minutes of talking time. So the more you practice, I think you're gonna have a really good time answering questions. But overall, big thumbs up from my end, Chaitanya. I think a very good interview session. So I would say keep your confidence, do some preparation, do a lot of rehearsal with your friends, family, talk to as many people as possible, keep on talking about yourself, practice your STAR answers. If you do all of this, you will get into any company you're shooting for.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Sure.
Awesome. Do you have any questions for me, Chaitanya?
No, sir. It's clear.
Awesome. Okay, Chaitanya, all the best. I'm excited to hear what happens next with you when the placement season begins.
Cheers. Thank you.
Okay, Chaitanya, have a good one. Bye-bye.
Nice. Thank you.